Open.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to another edition of It's the Arts. We kick off tonight with the cinema.
Good evening. One of the most prolific of film producers of this age, or indeed any age, is Sir Edward Ross, back in this country for the first time for 5 years to open a season of his works at the National Film Theatre, and we are very fortunate to have him with us here in the studio this evening.
Good evening.
Edward, you don't mind if I call you Edward?
No, not at all, fine.
Only it does worry some people. I don't know why, perhaps a little sensitive, so I do take the precaution of asking on these occasions.
No, that's fine. Forget.
So Ed was all right. Splendid.
Splendid.
Sorry to have brought it up, Ernie.
No, Edward it is.
Well, thank you very much indeed for being so helpful. Ernie, it's more than my job's worth to go on.
Quite, yes.
Makes it rather difficult to establish a rapport to put the other person at their ease.
Quite.
Yes, silly little point, but it does seem to matter. Still, less said the better. Ted, when you first started in the... You don't mind if I call you Ted?
No. Everyone calls me Ted. Right.
Well, it's shorter, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yes, and much less formal.
Yeah. Yep. Yes. Ted, Edward, anything.
Splendid. Incidentally, do call me Tom. I don't want you playing around with any of this Thomas nonsense. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Eddie Baby, when you first
I'm sorry. I don't like being called Eddie Baby.
I'm sorry?
I don't like being called Eddie Baby.
Did I call you Eddie Baby?
Yes, you did. Now get on with it.
Don't think I did call you Eddie Baby.
I didn't call you Eddie Baby.
Did I call him Eddie Baby?
No. Yes! No!
I didn't really call you Eddie Baby, did I, sweetie?
Don't call me a sweetie!
Can I call you Sugar Plum?
No!
Pussycat?
No!
Angel Drawers?
No, you may not! Now get on with it, Frank!
What? Can I call you Frank? Why Frank? It's a nice name. Robin Day's got a hedgehog called Frank.
Now, Frank.
What's going on?
Franny Nickerson.
No, face. I'm leaving.
Franny Nickerson.
I'm leaving. What? I'm off.
Tell us about your latest film, Sir Edward.
What?
Tell us about your latest film, if you'd be so kind, Sir Edward.
None of this pussycat nonsense.
Promise. Please, Sir Edward.
My latest film?
Yes, Sir Edward.
Well, the idea, funnily enough, came from an idea I had when I first joined the industry in 1919. Of course, in those days, I was only a tea boy.
Oh, shut up.
Sir Edward, Ross, now later in the programme, we'll be bringing you a unique event in the world of modern art. Pablo Picasso will be doing a special painting for us on this programme, live on a bicycle. This is the first time that Picasso has painted whilst cycling. But right now, it's time to look at a man whose meteoric rise to fame.
Last week, the Royal Festival Hall saw the first performance of a new symphony by one of the world's leading modern composers, Arthur Two Sheds Jackson. Mr. Jackson.
Good evening.
May I just sidetrack you for one moment, Mr. Jackson? This, what shall I call it, nickname of yours?
Oh, yes.
Two Sheds.
Yes.
How did you come by it?
Well, I don't use it myself. It's just a few of my friends call me Two Sheds.
I see. And do you, in fact, have two sheds?
No. I've only one shed. I've had one for some time. But a few years ago, I said I was thinking of getting another one, and since then, some people have called me Two Sheds.
In spite of the fact that you have only one?
Yes.
I see. And are you thinking of purchasing a second shed?
No.
To bring you in line with your epithet?
No.
I see. Well, let's return to your symphony. Now then, did you write this symphony in the shed?
No.
Have you written any of your recent works in this shed of yours?
No, it's just a perfectly ordinary garden shed.
I see. And you're thinking of buying the second shed to write in?
No, look, this shed business, it doesn't really matter at all. The sheds aren't important. It's just a few friends call me Two Sheds, and that's all there is to it. I wish you'd ask me about my music. I'm a composer. People are always asking about the shed, but they've got it out of proportion. I'm fed up with the shed. I wish I'd never got it in the first place.
I expect you're probably thinking of selling one.
Oh, I will sell one.
Then you'd be Arthur No Sheds Jackson.
Look, forget about the sheds. They don't matter.
Mr. Jackson, I think with respect we ought to talk about your symphony.
What?
Apparently your symphony was written for organ and timpani.
What's that?
What's what?
It's a shed. Get it off.
Right. Now then, Mr. Jackson, your symphony. I understand that you used to be interested in train spotting.
What?
I understand that about 30 years ago you were extremely interested in train spotting.
What's that got to do with my bloody music?
Are you having any trouble from him?
Yes, a little.
Well, we interviewers are more than a match for the likes of you, Two Sheds.
Yes, make yourself scarce, Two Sheds. Yeah. This studio isn't big enough for the three of us.
Get your own arts program, you fairy.
Arthur, Two Sheds, Jackson. Never mind, Timmy.
Oh, Michael, you're such a comfort.
Arthur, Two Sheds.
Jackson.